Hi folks, we're a little late on our next video because we've been, cutting trees down and mudding walls and ripping old legacy systems out of the house because, they're old legacy systems and they look like crap and you try to put a divot in your head every time you clean a litter box by lifting. Yeah, see, Miss Katie's laughing because she's, guess who cleans the litter boxes?
You do, for the most part.
I do. She cleans them...
when you tell me to.
When I tell her to. So, what game do we have today, Tootsie?
Horns of the Buffalo.
And it's designed by Bill.
You didn't tell me. Oh, Bill.
Yeah, so... Miss Katie has trouble staying away through either of my favorite two Zulu movies. Zulu Dawn, which... well, she actually kind of likes it once the Zulus appear on the screen, but it's kind of an overwrought movie. And Rourke's Drift, she has never really caught on to, even though it has a young Michael Caine. So, yes, I think that is, those two are solely guy movies. But we had a birthday the first of this month. Who had a birthday here?
Squirt.
Squirt, our kitten, had a birthday.
He is now 6 months old.
He's now 6 months old. He is, it's funny looking at the pictures of him when he was 4 weeks old. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah.
Miss Katie's been watching me play a lot of games lately. She's been sitting in the game room with me while I'm playing because she just enjoys my company so much. So. But, let's see, is there anything new otherwise?
Can't think of anything.
Just reading a lot for Ty Bomba's new game on Korea. Miss Katie got me Alan Millett's Korea 1950-51 up to the ebb and flow offensive. So, all right, folks, I'll be doing my thing here in a moment. And as always, she goes ahead and says...
bye-bye.
Bye-byes. Hi folks, it's Smitty. It is March the 3rd, as Miss Katie said. It is several days past our youngest child, Squirt. Squirt last night decided to play hockey with another small game, the Battle of the Mongahela. Decided to just... so... that was because Miss Katie called me over to the bedroom for something and I hadn't looked to see if someone had scooted in. So, you know, kittens will be kittens will be kittens. So, all right. Miss Katie talked to you earlier about the game, Horns of the Buffalo. This is our new one. It's by BMG, which is Bill Molyneaux Games. All right. As we talked about some friends today, that Bill has gone through several iterations of games. Two box games, fast play games, and each time, sort of, and there's Squirt's paws underneath the door. Each time has tried to move up in terms of professionalism, trying to make it better in terms of graphics and all. And this is a significant difference that he has moved from the fringes to sort of maybe double-A baseball with this. Okay. My overall sensing of this game and its components are it's a significant step upwards. And that Bill seems to be hitting his stride with this one. However... and there's always the however when he isn't there. And this is where Miss Katie just goes, you're going to get that feral smile. Matt, show this to you up in a little bit closer then. But can you see it clearly? Well, of course you can. It looks like that sort of funny netting that's often used with fishing stuff. Because it is very thin white lines. Why did you use black? I have trouble seeing this. Guess what? I think most of us my age to a little under my age and above my age are going to have trouble seeing this. This is a no-go. I don't know why he did that. That just makes no sense. Blue Panther, I think, should have been better. But don't you like that I blew up these counters? They are worlds above anything that Bill has put into a game before. They're very nice counters. They pop. Zulus only have melee and defensive strength here. The Brits have four. You've got melee strength, rifle strength, range here, and movement. It begins to look like a lock and load where you start to get your eyes all swirly because there's just too much stuff on here. I would have put them different places or something, but I don't know. Or I would at least move this up over here because this looks cluttered to me. But small things in comparison to the past. 70 counters, 35 on each side. Zulus have leaders and lots of Zulus. Lots of Zulus. The British have eight different kinds of counters, mainly infantry, but cavalry, Natal Rangers, and some others, rockets. The background used for the counters, though, man, they make them pot. The game scale and time of the game, though, I find a bit abstract. Well, and I think it's hard not to be because there are 12 scenarios. With 12 scenarios, it's hard to necessarily make it for this type of thing. But you could have said that. You could have noted that. And that's one of those things, the cradle to grave. Think of what your gamer's going to be thinking. Think of what your average gamer's going to be looking for and think that way. The rule book and the scenario book are both well laid out. They work well, except, let's see, which one is it? In Iswana, basically it is time to flee. How is flea spelled here, Miss Katie?
F-L-E-A.
In the summer here in Alabama, my dogs and cats, they get fleas. When they run away from me because they've got something dead in their mouth, they flee, F-L-E-E.
Right.
So, in the rule book, we've got the leader, L-E-A-D, hyphen, E-R, capitalized. Then we have leader later, in small case, lowercase. There's a lot of stuff like that. This is a little awkward, I found. Each unit has printed the maximum range, the first hex is the number printed, however, for each hex further away, minus one is subtracted from the combat value. Ooh, makes my head hurt.
Sounds like Monty Python.
It sounds like a Monty Python thing. Thou shalt not count past three. Thou shalt only count to three. Thou shalt not count to four. Whatever the routine is. The writing and the formatting leaves a lot to desire. The impression overall hurts the rest of the package. And it's a shame because TLC improving matters. It reminds me, folks, of the sequence after the second day, after the attack on Little Round Top, and Tom Chamberlain says, well, he died. Well, for here, the equivalent is, well, the rules are messy. You can't get around that. That's a simple and easy thing to do. Lots of people are happy to proof and get a free game. That just has to be done. This isn't
this isn't like a bad AI program writing for Sports Illustrated. This is simple stuff. Has to get done correctly. Okay, off that high horse. The Zulus are a closed to kill army. They have no rifle strength. They're strictly a melee army. They have to close, which means they're going to get pounded the whole time till they close. But the problem with that is the map seems perhaps a little small in order to maneuver. So I'm not fully certain, and that's only because I haven't played, folks. But just looking at it, I'm going, is that going to work right? I don't know. The weird thing I found here, the rules state there are stacks. Okay, that's no weird thing. Stacks are too high. But you fire at units individually in stacks, and now that is weird. It has to work that way because the way the combat system is set up. The combat system is a unit. This unit here who has a combat strength of 3 fires, and if he and to hit a Zulu, he has to fire a 3 or more. Correction, a 3 or under, but one's always hit no matter what the modifiers are. So, okay. But with a range of 4, then are they, and in fact, folks, that's the back side of the counters. They actually are 5 on offense. So, and the Zulus on offense, these are the back side, folks. I just know that, on are 7s. So the Zulus, if they get close to you, they're going to slam you. They're going to body slam you. But they've got to get close to you first. And you know from watching the movie, Zulu Dawn, the power of the British rifle. And then they ran into ammo problems. So, my conclusions. Good components. Really good components. And Walt Mahler on BGG made, I thought, an astute, a really astute observation. And that was, you know, I'm not buying this for Rourke's Drift. I'm not buying this for Iswana. I'm buying it for the other 10 scenarios because nobody's done these. I'm buying it for the uniqueness of that. I think that's a great thing. The positive here for Bill, the move to the better printer has very much paid off. That is a huge plus. And we're going to try right here now, folks, in front of you. We'll try it again. And now let's go to the Zulu because, being the good Lutheran boy that I am, 3 is a holy number. 3 for 3, no issue. All came out clean. Hallelujah. This will, without a doubt in my mind, fall within the same complexity and fun aspect of Bill's other games. But now, here we come down to this. Bill, have somebody proof for you. Have somebody be academically rigorous enough to look at this stuff, because as I tell my military students, you know, good ideas die lonely deaths, and good game ideas and good games can die from really awkward rule writing. And this isn't like the Battle of North Kursk, which we recently reviewed, where it's somebody tried to translate from the Japanese to English, and there were some tortured pieces of writing. So, the writing is maddening, Bill. The writing is going to be kind of maddening for anybody. But Bill is a great spokesman, logs a lot of hours for the game world, has great outreach, and he's working to grow the hobby by his outreach efforts. So, We're looking forward to this. As soon as we get done with Battle of the Mongahela, this is next. So as always, folks, we thank you. You have a blessed weekend, a blessed week, and get your taxes in on time. Thanks, everybody. We're done here.